Hello everyone, this is Artuelia. Today I am going to do a let's play of Valkyria Chronicles. Sorry, I'm just doing an accent. Valkyria Chronicles. And this is another great series made by, yes, Sega. I hope I don't sound too loud, but oh well. Anyways, yeah, this is just another great series that they made along with Sonic. But without further ado, I've already beaten this game. You know what? I might as well start a whole new thing for you guys. I mean, I will say I've beaten it, but like they will give me all the stuff that I've built up, and I will say in chapter one, we're wearing the costume of our, you know, in our military uniform, so I might as well do that. Yeah, I mean, I love this game. I mean, I wish it would be an all-star of, like, Sega All-Stars with Sonic and Valkyria Chronicles and whatever. It amassed troops along the eastern border and invaded with all the force of an avalanche. It would have been cool if they would have been in Super Smash, because apparently now Cloud is in Smash. Okay, well, I don't even have to do all this sort of stuff. Blah 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 blah, blah. I already get it. Blah blah blah. Music. The time you can listen to tracks from the sound used throughout the. Ooh, I forgot about that. Hold on, I want to go to music. What? I can't go to music? Oh, that's so sad. Well, I might as well start on this.
March 1935. Outside the Galleon border town of Brule. Residents are leaving the town before the invasion, headed inland towards the capital.
I haven't been down this road in years. It really hasn't changed very much.
I will say, like, when my cousin Corey told me about this series, he was telling me, like, well, like, he showed me a review back in 2010, and gosh, that was, like, an epic moment for me. He was talking, like, it showed the date, March 1935, and he was telling me, like, you know, see, this is before World War II, like, you know, with Nazi Germany rising about and all that. And so I was thinking this is just some other war somewhere in Europe that took place before World War II. Yeah, I mean, this game is just, they take remnants from, yeah, historical facts of the real war, put it all together, and you have this with fantasy. And the thing is, the creators of this game, they had to watch Band of Brothers and Saving Private Ryan just to get the idea of, you know, World War II in Europe. So I thought that was pretty awesome. Anyways, like I said, though, they're going to be wearing, like, the uniforms that they have when they're in the military, because I've already beaten the game. And this is, like, an extra thing that you could do if you want to go through it again. It gives you all the equipment that you build up, and then, you know, leveling up your character, so now you'll be double time. Like, you'll be double the amount as you were when you first played. So yeah, see, but oh well, it's all right. I'm just gonna send Alicia all the way over here. Oh, look at these! I'm so invisible right now. Now you're going to die. I'm having a trouble with my PSP right now, like. I'm still, like, I've already beaten Valkyria Chronicles 2, but I'm going through it again. Like, I've beaten this a long time ago, but I wanted to go through it again. So I've already beaten this now with the PSP. I beat it, and I'm doing it again. But the problem is my stupid analog stick for some reason is acting stupid. It's a little messed up now. And man, does it ruin a little bit of the game experience because it just goes up and down and up and down. I don't even know what the heck happened. It was all right though, like last time I played it. All of a sudden, it's like, why? Why is it doing this to me? No. This game is pretty epic. Now they're coming. Now they've already come back with it on with the PS4. Funny coincidence is my cousin and I made a game discussion video about just Sega. And I mentioned this about Valkyria Chronicles and Sonic and Bayonet and blah blah blah. And then the day I uploaded it and put it up for everyone to see on Tumblr and Facebook and all, there was a trailer announcement for the PS4 version of Valkyria Chronicles, and it was like perfect timing. I know, in Valkyria Chronicles 2, you could get the Sonic sticker to put on your tank, which is pretty awesome. The thing is, it's too bad this didn't have online.
I don't see any more of them.
No. Crouch. See, right now I'm just invisible because of all the leveling up I did. Now I'm kind of in a conflict between if I want to get the PS4 version. I actually have all Uncharted games, and I have now the new Uncharted, the Uncharted Legacy Collection or something like that. You know, I was thinking, you know, I wonder if I should just sell the old ones, but you know, if you're a game collector, you might as well keep it. After Uncharted 2 and 3 have multiplayer.
My turn, okay?
That's right. They say the general's an aristocrat. He looks down on the common militia.
That doesn't make any sense.
Right. Now that the war's begun, we all need to band together and fight to keep Gallia safe. Who cares at this point whether you're in the army or the militia? It's ridiculous.
Yeah, and the thing is, during World War II, there was always a competition between Montgomery, Patton, and Britain, and America. You know, it was ridiculous. I mean, it was really just supposed to help stop the Nazis from, you know, doing what they were doing. And it was really, they should have just focused on that instead of political game. You know, it was just almost like a game of who would be better to beat the other side. But really, I mean, we were all allies, we were helping out, but that little game was kind of silly, I will say.
The name's Vice Engelbart. Let's go kick this war in the teeth.
And what's funny, another Easter egg about this Valkyria Chronicles is that guy Weissel is from Skies of Arcadia, another Sega game, which was cool. Thing is, these guys are no match for my tank. Because watch this, I could blow them up into smithereens, boom. Bye bye! Goodbye, enemy forces. Now, I will say, I may have to build up my tank some more to make it where it could go a little bit longer. The meter, so it could go longer of a distance. Alright. So what I'm going to do is I'll lead maybe at least Alicia and my other squads over here. And then what I'm going to do next is lead the other team on inside the city and blow up the tanks. Maybe build up my machine gun stuff again. Guns and stuff, grenades. Make them even more stronger. So that way whenever I... Thing is, if I go and decide to buy a new version, might as well just play that.
Enemy sighted. Enemy unit spotted. Think you can stop me?
No one can stop you, Alicia. You're double times the amount of these guys. We're moving in.
What is that thing?
Found an enemy.
So, some of these guys, like this guy and also the other guy, sounds like Roger Craig Smith. That does Sonic now. And he was also Zoggy, and he was also in Naruto. Yeah, she's got the heavy gun. Okay, time to bring out Largo.
Been waiting here.
I know you've been waiting here, Largo. Now you're up. See, and that's the thing. This game really challenges you whenever you try to aim for something. It just does not work sometimes. Okay, I'm gonna go around. Don't worry, Logger will be fine. Actually, I'll go all the way. One tank down. See, we're just dropping them like flies, and they just don't even know. Well, they're already dead, so obviously. I will say Valkyria Chronicles is, Valkyria Chronicles 2 is good. Thing is, though, like, you can't continue on with a story until you, like, play like these key missions, so that's kind of like a I mean, it gives you time to level up and all, which is nice, but then again, you kind of want to move on too. Now this guy is from, yes, Skies of Arcadia. Okay, rumor has it he hails from a nation far removed from your bleak circumstances only excite him all the more, and luckily he has an iron will. Once he starts talking about this guy, he doesn't stop. He left the militia for parts unknown on a new adventure. No galleon has seen him ever since he boarded a ship at a sleeping crossroads in the morning fog. That is so cool, because in Skies of Arcadia, he's a pirate, but I guess you could say he's a sky pirate. That's what he is. Yeah, I'm sure most of you people probably have played Skies of Arcadia, but yeah, he's a pirate, a sky pirate. And yeah, like, the mention of this, I guess, I wonder if Skies of Arcadia takes place, if it takes place, like, after Valkyria Chronicles. Sometimes I wonder, but I think that's pretty cool that they would put him in there and mention, like, he's far, like, he lives far off from Europa, and he does, but he's a sky pirate, and not just him. There she is, right here. Yeah, this is her. She's also from Skies of Arcadia, child friend and co-conspirator. She came with him from a far off land, for adventure, and half to keep him in line. Only makes her stronger as she turns any problem around to resolution. The only two things that can stop this vibrant girl are ghosts and roaches. She left Gallia for places unknown on a new adventure for untold treasure with the new comrades she'd found in Squad 7, there at her side. Oh, so maybe they went on a journey into the skies from Skies of Arcadia. Ain't that swell? Together with their newfound friends. And see, she's also from Skies of Arcadia. So, Yena and Finna. I'm sure most of these characters are in here. I wish they would have had also maybe like Shining Force characters, because I mean, you know, they're in there. They're in here. I mean, that's part of Sega. Anyways, I'll see you guys later. Peace.